So here we are in the Click Chemistry lab in Cold Spring Harbour.
Barry is going to do a reaction in the lab. He's going to do a polymerization reaction. I'm just going to show you the reaction he's going to do. So we're going to react this monomer with this monomer. And what's going to happen? You're going to exchange this fluorine with this silicon group. So what we've done now is made a bond between the oxygen and the sulfur, so we've made a connection. But of course, because we've got another oxygen silicon bond here and another sulfur fluorine bond here, well, the same thing's going to happen. So another group's going to come in. Same thing again. This is going to react here with this and exchange. We're going to form a bond here. And as you can see, this thing's just going to keep on going because we'll have another molecule of this come in and then that'll react here. And they'll react here, and what happens, we just end up making a real long polymer chain. And it happens really fast, and it's really efficient. This is Dr. Josh Homer, and he's going to show you the practical polymerization reaction in the lab. So these are the two reagents we described earlier, the two monomers. So Josh, off you go. So that's one coupling partner, and in goes the other, but nothing's going to happen yet. We need to add some solvent. What are we using, Josh?
DMF.
Which is?
Dimethyl formamide.
The monomers are pretty soluble, but just to help them on the way, we're going to heat it up a little bit just to get them nice and soluble. Cool. So now we're going to let it stir a little bit, maybe cool down a little bit, just to take the edge off it. And then Professor Sharpless is going to come along and add the magic catalyst.
The catalyst, it's all or nothing at all. The thing's really like a rock without the catalyst.
And this was developed at Cold Spring Harbour Lab, this particular catalyst?
Yes,
it's
right.
So this is a proud moment for us.
Okay, go. Are we ready?
Go. You can't really see what's happening, because that's a molecular level, you don't really see anything. But as it proceeds, the polymer becomes more insoluble. As the molecule gets longer, it becomes less soluble. Eventually we'll start to see some material crashing out of the solution. Right, let's see what happens now. Hopefully the material should crash out. And you can see little like fibers appear, right, in the solution?
Yeah, they're squiggly.
I don't know, it looks almost like, what do you call the moths that make silk?
Yeah.